over the model, I want to review for you on this picture real quick what we're looking at. We've got the superior vena cava. We're talking about the hepatic portal system, okay? And so we've got this the hepatic portal vein and its major branches. There's other branches. If you look at another book or something, you might, an atlas, you might see some other branches. We're not going to go into detail on all those. We're just going to talk about these: the hepatic portal vein, the splenic vein, the superior mesenteric, and the inferior mesenteric. And as you remember, the splenic, of course, comes from the spleen. The inferior mesenteric are coming from all the small intestine, the ascending, the right colic flexure, and the transverse colon, where the inferior mesenteric are coming from the left colic flexure and the descending colon and the transverse, or the sigmoid colon, sorry. Okay, so looking at that, we also up here, we have the hepatic vein. So what happens is the hepatic portal system is bringing blood back from the intestine into the liver where it's filtered and then back into the vena cava through these hepatic veins. Okay, now to look at a picture, what's confusing about the models we have in the lab is you've got to realize, and it's noticed on this picture, that this is imposed, this is underneath these structures. It's underneath the pancreas, or posterior, I should say, to the pancreas and the stomach back here. So if you look at our models, it you've got to realize how this is. And I got to show you my chest for just a second to show you how this goes. This is actually sits in me like this. Okay? So this is, we're looking at this from this direction. Okay? So if we turn this over and look at this, you can see that we have the splenic artery and splenic vein. And here is the hepatic portal vein with the common bile duct with the gallbladder. Here is the superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein. And here's the inferior mesenteric vein. So once again, splenic vein, inferior mesenteric vein, superior mesenteric vein into the hepatic portal vein. So now, once again, looking at this intestinal tract from the anterior is like this, but if we turn it over and look at it from the back, if you notice, the arteries are in red, which on most models, arteries are, but the hepatic portal veins are purple. If you notice if you look at other atlases, you might often see the veins of the hepatic portal system in purple to depict that they are a little different. They are from the hepatic portal system and not just regular veins. But if you look at this now, we're looking at this is the right side and the left side. So this over here, this is a superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein. This is the inferior mesenteric artery with a branch of the inferior mesenteric vein. Now, once again, to show you how this works, this is a very schematic drawing of the hepatic portal system. And you can see that here is the liver, here's the spleen, here is the hepatic portal vein, and the splenic vein, where we have the superior mesenteric vein and the splenic, where the anastomose becomes the hepatic portal vein, and the inferior mesenteric, of course, going into the splenic. Those of you who have this handout can make this make sense to you better, and I don't know if this will show up on the camera, but if you turn this around this way, it'll show you how the model is. But once again, here's the spleen, liver, so splenic, hepatic portal vein, superior mesenteric, inferior mesenteric. How you doing, Justin?